Yeah, so we are going to discuss on eye injuries in sports, and this is one of the most important topics for sports vision. What we need to understand is most of the sports injuries, they can be prevented. You know, these sports injuries obviously are preventable, and when we say they are preventable, it has a larger understanding to it, because in the history of sports there have been incidences where there have been injuries to the eye in various situations played during various tournaments, national and international tournaments, where it has had an effect on the athlete's eyes. And when you understand as a practitioner that these injuries could have been prevented by proper means and by proper practices, it is more important for us to understand and study different eye injuries in sports. The effects of these injuries can range from person to person, and it could differ from situation to another situation depending upon the sport that has been played. The effect could be at a primary level. For example, it could give rise to an eye injury causing eyelid laceration or corneal aberration. But what can be more dangerous is the possibility of some secondary changes occurring due to a blow or a hit on the eye. When I say secondary changes, it could also give rise to secondary cataract due to a hit on the eye through a cricket ball. Or at times we have seen, it has been recorded in research, suggests that boxers who play combat sports, they tend to develop retinal detachments after prolonged years of playing boxing. So what is most important is that proper efforts should be taken to prevent these injuries by two modes. And these two modes are, the first and the most important mode is proper coaching. So at the level of coaching to these athletes, there has to be an awareness among the athletes to practice and play the sport by maintaining proper safety of their health, and most importantly their eye health. The second mode is by providing these athletes important and necessary protective eyewears wherever applicable, whichever sport they are playing. If there is a possibility of wearing an protective eyewear, it is necessary that the athlete should be encouraged to wear that eyewear. Now there are some common sports which are involved which could cause eye injuries, and those sports are something that we watch and observe day in, day out. The first common sport is racquet sports. When I say racquet sports, it is about a sport like squash, or we also consider badminton, we also consider long tennis under the category of racquet sports. And interestingly, these racquet sports are one of the most common causes of sports injuries to the eye. And one reason that it gives rise to eye injury is because the projectile which is used to play a sport like racquet sport, for example a tennis ball or a shuttlecock, it moves fast. It moves really fast. And the average speed of these at which these projectile move is approximately 50 to 55 meters per second. It is that fast that this projectile moves, and it is approaching the opponent, and it could hit the body of the opponent. But what is most worse is that there is a possibility that it could also hit the eye of the opponent. the most dangerous considered sport in racket sport is squash, because it is played at a tremendous speed, and the athlete is moving, the squash ball is hit, it is moving fast, the opponent is expected to move fast and hit the ball. So there's a lot happening in that court where that squash is played, where there is a possibility of an eye injury to occur. It has also been recorded that games like badminton and tennis, they tend to have more possibility of ocular injuries when they are played with as doubles game, especially when tennis is played as single tennis. The likelihood of any ocular injury is rare, whereas when a doubles game is played, there is a very high possibility of eye injuries, and which is the reason why very commonly we observe that elite athletes, when they play doubles, they hold their racket right in front of their face, so that they know that it is necessary to react at a time, and any possible delay in reaction to the projectile or the tennis ball or the shuttlecock may actually end up into ocular injury or a facial injury. So these are important sports. We watch them very often, but very little do we know that these are potential sports which could cause ocular injuries. The second type of sport that we observe and which can have a possibility, high possibility of eye injuries, is our large ball sports. For example, football. For example, soccer, where the ball used to play the game is larger in diameter, and sometimes the ball itself can be the cause of the injury. What is very common in a game like football or a game like soccer is at times there is this concept of headers, where the athlete is expected to hit the ball by their head, and unfortunately, sometimes when there is a mistimed header, where the athlete is unable to hit the ball through his head, there is a possibility that the ball may actually hit the athlete's eye, which could give rise to an ocular injury. What is also common in these games like soccer is sometimes it is played at such a high speed and with so much of aggression that there is a possibility that the athlete, while running in the moment of the game, unfortunately could get hit by the hand of the opponent, or sometimes there is a clash amongst two players in order to hit the ball, and sometimes there is a possibility that the opponent's head could hit your eye, and that could also give rise to a potential eye injury. What is a good part that we have been observing for last few years is some of these sports where a large ball is used, for example basketball, athletes have started using eye protectors. It has been a revolution. Basketball players have started using eye protectors. Unfortunately, not all games and not all athletes enjoy the benefit of eye protectors, especially a game like soccer or a football. If played with eye protectors, it could definitely change the way the game has been played, and maybe the players might not produce the same efficacy as an athlete with the limitations of wearing an eye protector. But one good part about basketball is that these athletes have started using polycarbonate eye protectors, which are a great source of eye protection. The other type of sport which can give rise to possible eye injuries are bat and stick sports, and very commonly we call it as hockey. We observe games like ice hockey, field hockey, and the most common game that is played is cricket, which is also categorized as a bat and stick sport. Now, the possibility of injury in cricket, ocular injury in cricket, is rare, unless unless there is an untoward situation where the athlete has not been very attentive and he has missed the approaching ball and it hits the eye of the athlete, or possibly if there is a batsman who is not wearing a headgear and the ball hits the eye of the batsman, that could also be a potential threat to the eye and potential injury cause. But otherwise, cricket per se has been a safer game from the ocular point of view. But a game like hockey is definitely a game which could be damaging at times if not played with proper safety. So we have so far covered some important sports which started from racquet sports to large ball sports, and the third one was bat and stick sports. The last 10 very important sport that we will discuss is combat sport. For example, sports like boxing, judo, karate, or you know, any sport where there is an opponent who is attacking you either by their hands, by fist, or sometimes there is a sport which mimics the ancient sport of sword fighting, which is also played in Olympics, and we observe that game played with proper headgears and proper protections. So there is a possibility of some sort of ocular injury while playing these combat sports, and that proper attention has to be given to the safety of the eye. And the two most important modes where safety can be assured is, the first mode is proper coaching. The coach should be aware of the possible methods of providing safety to the athlete's eye. And the second most important mode is by providing protective eyewear wherever possible. Thank you very much.